end of the fetus. I'm going to briefly explain in this tutorial how we determine the fetal sex using medical ultrasound. In this particular instance, I am going to discuss this case study of a patient I scanned who had a boy fetus. What you're seeing here is the placenta that actually feeds the fetus, and what is here is the fluid surrounding the fetus, which is called the amniotic fluid. Then what we have here are the fetal testicles. So this is an indicator of a male genitalia. So let me do it like this. If you look here, you can actually see the testicles, then you can see the male genitalia here. This is a male fetus. This is how we determine the sex of the fetus. Some people, they have got an illusion that maybe it's the machine that actually predicts the sex of a fetus, of which it is the practitioner, the clinician, who upon scanning is the one who can then say this is a male or a fetus. So fetal sex determination is a skill that is acquired by practitioners. So if a practitioner is not all that skilled, he might actually, or she might actually, miss the sex of a fetus. So to determine the sex of fetus, it needs reorienting the patient so that the fetus can actually have the legs opened and you can actually better visualize. Let me explain this sign, which is called the turtle sign. So when you're doing an ultrasound scan for a male patient, basically you look at what we call the turtle sign, which is a representative of our male genitalia. So these are the testicles and this is the penile part. So this is what is called the turtle sign. So when you're doing the ultrasound scan and then you see this turtle sign, you should be assured that you are seeing a boy fetus. Let us do it this way again. You can see the turtle sign. You can see the turtle sign here. So this is our testicles. Then at the front here, that's the penile part. So this is the what you call the turtle sign. Amniotic fluid. So in between the legs here, that's where we see our turtle sign. So that's the technique that we use to actually identify and differentiate a male from a fetal genitalia in utero or in the womb. So you can see nicely here that this is 100% a boy positive turtle sign. Again, coming to this, you can see nicely our positive turtle sign, our testicles, and the male genitalia. You can see the penile part here, and then there's our placenta here. So we actually use this amniotic fluid as a window for us to be able to visualize the fetal genitalia. When there is no free fluid here, or when we have a condition that is called oligohydramnios with reduced amniotic fluid here, it might be difficult for us to differentiate or to appreciate the genitalia of a fetus. Why? Because the walls of the uterus or the placenta, as it were, is going to overlap. If this placenta comes and overlaps this testicular part, you cannot be able to differentiate the two. So this amniotic fluid, when it is adequate, it actually works as a window for us to determine the fetal genitalia with ease. So in brief, this is it in terms of fetal determination. So when the practitioner misses the sex of the fetus in utero, it is not because the machine lies. It's not the machine. This is actually the skill employed by the practitioner At the same time, if the practitioner is not honest enough to say that he or she cannot see the sex at that particular time, it might end up in a misappropriation. Then you'll be disappointed as a patient. Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. I hope you are blessed. Continue watching my videos. Also subscribe. If you have any comments, type the comments under the comment section, then we will respond. Thank you so much.